So put this just like this. Before you do anything else. Is everybody clear on what I did? Okay, just like that. Now you put your x's in here. So what's my x in this one right here? 5. What's my x in this one right here? A negative 2. That's going to be a double. What's my y in this one? Guys, I'm getting a lot of talking while I'm teaching, and I'm not going to accept that, okay? I appreciate you trying to help, but right now I'm teaching, okay? When I'm finished, you can help. So my y in this one is what?
-7.
And what's my y in this one?
4.
And now I work it out. So this right here is going to be 7 squared, which is going to be 49. This one right here is going to be a negative 11, but when you square it, it's going to become a positive 121. So I don't know. I'm getting 100 and whatever that is. Thank you. Okay, 170. And then I take my calculator and I press on this one now. Everybody's a little different. So I'm going to press 170 shift and square root. However you do it, you should get 13.0. And I want you to put that .0 because that indicates that it wasn't exactly 13. There's more to it, okay? And we'll talk about rounding, but for right now, I know you're like, well, 13.0 means nothing. It does, because it means there's more back there. All right, we'll go on to the last one here. And actually, to save you some time, I really don't want to go on to number 6. Does anybody know the answer to it? All right, I saw something different. Might be. Anybody else had something different? All right, maybe I should do it. So number 6 looks like this. So I get a negative 7 and a negative 4. I get a 5 and a negative 2. So this becomes a plus. And that one becomes a plus. So it looks like I get 9 plus 49, which gives me the square root of 58, I think. Did anybody else get the square root of 58? Okay, that's what I'm going to go with. So look at your work and see if you have that. Now let's just, for kicks and giggles, let's see what it is. We're going to get 7.6 as my answer. Any questions on how to do number 6? If you don't have that, you need to find out why. Any questions about what I did? All right, put away your bell work. Draw this diagram, and I want you to locate the points and find the distance. Locate the points and find the distance. Where are the points located at? Now again, if you can't find the points correctly, then obviously you're going to miss it. No matter how good you are with the distance plot. So part of the process here is, do you know how to plot a point? We talked about that yesterday. Remember, your x comes first. Now I'm going to give you the points in a minute because I don't want you wasting your time doing the distance formula, because you got the points wrong. So I'm going to give you a minute to try to figure it out on your own. Can anybody tell me where point A is? -3, because you're going left, and then up 2, so that's correct. And where is point B at? 2 and -3. All right. Make sure you understand that because, I mean, you could be real good with the distance formula, but if you can't find these points, obviously you can't do the distance formula. So right now, please do the distance formula. Okay, I get the square root of 50. Anybody else got that? All right, we'll stay with that. Now, if you didn't get it, find out what you're doing wrong. I need everybody to be able to do the distance formula. All right, today's work is right here. You're going to finish up the workbook, and while you're doing that, I'm going to check the homework in. So I think we left off on 6, and so you're going to finish up whatever is in the workbook. And I'll videotape it because some of you may not finish. So let's see. I think this is 1.2. So in the workbook, don't waste time, okay? Try to get this done. Let's see if I can give you some credit. Okay, page 281, and I'm going to go ahead and pull this off a minute because I need to. 281.